Hello everyone. Today we will demo the Approvals tile in PeopleSoft Finance. While in the past, users had to manage multiple pages and worklists, the Approvals tile streamlines and condenses this process. After logging in, you will see your My Finance homepage. The Approvals tile will display a count of the documents currently pending your approval. In this example, you can see that there are 25 documents pending approval. To access your work, simply click on the Approvals tile. Note, you can also access your approval work from almost any page in PeopleSoft Finance by clicking the nav bar and selecting the Approvals icon. For more information on how to navigate PeopleSoft Finance, please watch our Navigation Basics video. The Approvals tile is broken into two parts, the Transaction Category area and the List area. The Transaction Category area is seen on the left-hand side of the screen. In this area, transactions are grouped together into categories based on the chosen option in the View By dropdown. The List area contains transactions that belong to the selected categories from the left. After clicking the tile, the View By dropdown is set automatically to Type, with All chosen as the default. This ensures that the List area displays all transactions that are pending your approval. To apply some basic sorting, let's review the choices at our disposal by clicking the View By dropdown. Date Routed will group transactions based on when they were routed for your approval. Like the other View By choices, a number is displayed by each line that shows how many transactions are in each group. Additionally, clicking a group changes the List area to display only the transactions that meet those criteria. Choosing Last Updated By will list transactions by the individual who last changed some aspect of the document. Examples include the person who submitted the transaction, any entry delegates that added and saved information, or the last approver to review. Selecting priority is currently not viable, as users are unable to set their own priority, so we will skip this option. The Submitted For option will group transactions by the individual listed on the document, such as the cardholder on a reconciling expense report. Choosing Type allows a user to focus on one kind of document at a time. Finally, a user can use the Filter button to apply multiple filters simultaneously. As each transaction type has different requirements on what is allowable per university policy, we will only review a few documents based on the functionality of the Approvals tile. For more information on policy and how to pay for goods and services, please reach out to your local accounting office or the Finance Support Center. Let's review an expense report to begin. As the header page has so much information on display, we will only briefly describe each section. The top section contains information about who the document is paying, reimbursing, etc., as well as the Actions button that allow you to approve or send the ER back as appropriate. The Summary section will vary by the type of transaction you are reviewing. However, one of the more important aspects of this section is a link to the Funding Overview page. This page was developed as a one-stop shop way to review the funding for the entire document. The Attachments and Notes section will only populate if a header attachment or note was added to the document. The Lines section contains rows that allow a user to drill down for additional line-level information. In the case of reviewing expense reports, clicking a line allows you to review any line-level attachment. Additionally, expense reports allow a reviewer to toggle between any lines pending their approval and all lines on the ER. In this case, there are 16 rows pending our approval, but 37 rows total. After reviewing and selecting the lines to approve or push back, click one of the buttons located in the top right. For now, we will go back to the Pending Approvals page and choose a requisition. This will allow us to do a quick compare of differences in the document types, as well as explore our workflow ad hoc options. As you can see, the sections are set to allow for some consistency between approving different kinds of transactions. One of the differences is the More button located in the top right. This button appears because there are more ways for a reviewer to interact with a requisition, including the ability to deny the transaction or put it on hold. Additionally, instead of a funding link, we are able to review the View Line Details button. Although the functionality is similar, this button opens a new tab for users to review. After reviewing a requisition, if you determine it needs routed to another individual, you will select the lines to approve, then click the Approval Chain link. Clicking the plus button will let you add another individual to the approval chain. If you would like to review what transactions you have approved, navigate back to the Pending Approvals page. Clicking the Actions icon and selecting the Approvals History option brings you to a page with similar functionality to the Pending Approvals page, including the same filter options. Note that your history will only display the last 30 days worth of approvals. This concludes our basic approvals training. If you have any trouble with the features discussed in this video, or would like a more detailed review of the approvals tile, please access the FAQ tile for additional training resources.